Hey guys, welcome back to CMTEQ channel. So I hope by now you were able to watch part one of this tutorial where we basically showed how to calculate a voltage drop on a feeder system. As you can see here, so we got the current of each one of the sections and the resistance as per the cable parameters that were provided to us, okay? And the tutorial was getting a bit too long, so we stopped it at some point. And if you were not able to get the values of the voltage drop of each one of these sections, then you are at the right place, because at the end of this tutorial I'm going to show you quickly how to get these simple impedance or complex calculations of voltages and currents. And also, please don't forget to give this tutorial a thumbs up and subscribe to CMTEQ channel. Here at CMTEQ channel, it is a place where you're going to find great tutorial on the most important topic on power systems, electronics, and programming. Right, now without wasting any further time, let's dive into our calculation. Okay, now let's finish it off. So the voltage drop on this section AB, so that's going to be VAB. So we say VAB. Now VAB is going to be the current on this section, okay? The current of this section times the impedance of the section. Now what is the current of this section? Now remember, the current of this section is this current here, okay? Because we took this current 100 with an angle of negative 45 and we added it with this current, okay? So which means this one here, VAB, is going to be, where is the impedance? That's a 100 meter section, so it's going to be 0,028 with an angle of 26,56 times our current. It's going to be 285, right, with an angle of negative 30. Okay, so this gives you a voltage drop of 7,98 with an angle of negative 3,44 degree volt. Okay, so you basically have an approximate voltage drop of 8 volt on this section here. Okay, now let's go ahead and find the voltage drop on section BC. So VBC. Again, guys, if you find this useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. That will be highly appreciated. So VBC, now remember the current here is 200 amp, not 120, okay? So it's 200 amp. So that was a combination of the 120 plus the 80 that we got here, okay? There we go, 120 and the 80. So that's 190. So our current is 190 with an angle of negative 22.2, okay, times, okay, let's not forget the comma 15 there, times the impedance of the section. Remember, the both impedances are the same, so that is going to be 0,042, okay, 0,042 with an angle of 26.56 degree ohm, okay, and this will give us a value of 7.98 with a positive angle of 4,36 degree volt. So the magnitude is basically almost 8 volt as well. So you also have about 8 volt dropping here and 8 volt dropping there of magnitude. Now we can go ahead and do the last part, so that will be VCD. So VCD, okay, we know what's the current in this last part, it's a 80, so that will be 80 with a 0 degree angle. Our impedance is the same impedance as this, is 0,042 angle 26.56 degree, okay, and that will give us a voltage drop of 3,36 with an angle of 26.52 degree volt. Okay, so you've got about 3,36 volt here. Okay, now from here, clearly you can already see the combined magnitude of your voltage drop here. Now, if you want the sum, you basically just have to add all of them, okay? So it's going to be your VT, let's just say V total, V drop total, so V drop, okay, across your line here. So your voltage drop across the line is going to be that 7.98 with an angle of negative 344 plus another 7.98 this time with an angle of 436 plus 3.36 with an angle of 2652. Okay, summing all of this. So basically summing it all up give you a voltage drop of 18.99 with an angle of 4.9. So you basically can approximate this to be 19 volt with an angle of 5 degrees. Okay, so that is basically the voltage drop across this line here. So now we don't know what was the voltage here that was sent here, that we do not have that information. But now assume that this was indeed a 230 volt that we made an assumption here, then you have to minus the 19 volt. Okay, because remember your sending voltage angle, okay, is always going to have an angle of 0 degrees, so which means 230 volt minus this 19 here, so you're going to expect a voltage here of about 211, okay, 211 volt. So 211 volt is way below the 5%. So now this is an alarm need to go off, because now this cannot be accepted. You will need a voltage stabilizer to continue to live in this street here. Otherwise you need to call your energy supplier, right, your ESCOM, your power distributor, to come and fix the problem in this line here, so that your house can have a stable electricity. So that is it, guys, for this tutorial. I hope you found something interesting here to learn. And just before you go, now imagine if you have a situation in this network configuration where you've got a leading power factor into the system, because right now we've got an inductive or a lagging power factor and another lagging power factor with a resistive power factor of 1. Now if you introduce a leading power factor here, now what will be the effect on your overall current of the system here and your overall voltage drop? So that is very interesting to see. So drop a comment on the comment section and try to change this power factor to a leading power factor instead of a lagging power factor, and redo the calculation and see if it's going to change the overall system voltage drop, and let me know on the comment section. So until next time, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to CMTEQ channel. Cheers.